Hello. Hi. I'm not happy. I'm not so happy. I woke up this morning and turned on the TV set and I saw our super falcons protesting about their unpaid allowances. And I was wondering, what's wrong with us? As a nation, what's wrong with us? How can we have people that volunteered their time, their energy, part of their resources, risked even their lives to travel out of this country, to represent the country, and coming back with glory, only for them not to be paid their own allowances? So they conquered Africa, came back to their homeland, only to start protesting for something that should be their right. What is wrong with us? And I'm trying to find where the problem is coming from, and I'm just thinking here and there. Firstly, we have a minister who came out after they won and was lamenting that they didn't expect that these people were going to win the competition. And I'm trying to analyze how sane that statement sounds. These are super falcons that have won this competition for more than 5 times. And when they were leaving, most likely you gave them pep talk to encourage them. So how would you tell me that as a ministry, you did not believe they were going to win? Then why did you sponsor their going in the first place? And how can you support people that you don't believe would win? And you're supposed to be leading them. You are the Minister of Youth and Sports Development. And for God's sake, that is not even making sense anymore. How would you join the Ministry of Youth and that with the Ministry of Sports? Sports is not just only about football. There's table tennis, there's cricket, there's boxing. It's a whole big picture on its own. And then when you're talking about youths, don't think it's just sports only, because there are youths that are technocrats, they are involved in technology, there are youths that are involved in business or agriculture, or some other field outside sports. So the Constitution, if it's made that provision, is wrong on that. And that's why sometimes I hope that sometimes we can even suspend this Constitution and erase some things that are not making sense anymore. The Ministry of Sports should be on its own. The Ministry of Youth Development should be on its own. Majority of the Nigerian population are youths. We should have a Ministry of Youth Development. We should have a Ministry of even Entrepreneurship Development. A Ministry of Sports Development. Because we are still an underdeveloped nation, not even developing itself. So all these ministries should be in tag development. So he comes on and says such. The same person that came on air a while back to say that our super ego should not bother going to World Cup because he knows they are not going to win. What is that kind of person still doing in office? And I'm thinking, do I blame him or blame the person that put him there? Or blame us for even sitting still and looking? We can do something about all this nonsense we are seeing all around us as young people. You love football, you love Arsenal, you love Man U, you love Real Madrid, Barca, Juventus, AC Milan, whatever club, Chelsea, whatever club you support. But can we take it a step further? Can we begin to think about sport administration in our colleges of education? Can you begin to think of the business of sports, not just arguing about who is the best player, Ronaldo or Messi, and busting bottle on your head? Let's begin to think of how we can affect our sports ministry. You may not be a football player, but you could understand football and begin to develop yourself. And then we have a youth looking at getting in such a position and doing things that are right. We have a Ministry of Youth. Imagine a Ministry of Youth led by a Fela Durotoye. We won't be talking about unemployment the way we are talking about it now, or underemployment, because these are people that have sense, that have passion for young people. Please, let's get to work. Let's get to work. Let's get things working. Because when I see these men speak the way they speak, it angers my spirit, man. It angers me. You have a passion for football, take it higher. Let's do something that makes sense. Football is one of the most loved sports in Nigeria. If we can fix football, we can unite Nigeria more than we can imagine. And I trust that this government better do something and pay those girls on time before they and save us from further embarrassment. I'm out.